Right, so that was that for this video.
Okay.
Well, that was that, guys, for
Dang, why is it so hard?
Alright, so we are back to finish up the outline we started. We're about to paint it right now. So painting is actually the part of the picture where the beauty of your work is actually realized. So what I explained in the beginning of the video was that I was explaining about the outline. You should cover up your outline. Guys, cover up the outline. There should be no space in your outline because you need that when you are painting. Alright, so what I usually do when I'm painting on Procreate is I use the select tool here. Tap on the select tool, then go to automatic. So because my whole outline is completely covered, what I'll tap on these edges, on this part of the background, just fills those parts off. So I'm basically selecting the outer part of the picture, which is like the background.
So sometimes, like what you just saw, when you try to fill up a particular corner of your picture, it fills into the wrong areas. That's because your outline isn't completely covered. So you can either completely cover the outline or just slide down your threshold and Procreate will automatically understand. So just slide down, just holding the background you are trying to select and slide it down. That's all.
Alright, so now I'm done selecting the outer part of the picture, which is the background. I'm going to tap on freehand and invert this. So then what I'm going to do now is add up my reference, because I already use a reference whenever I'm painting. Already use a reference. So I'm going to add up my reference right now. If you are using Infinite Painter to make your painting, when you are about to import a picture, you see the option to add the photo as a reference. So on Procreate, I just slide up my gallery and put it right at the corner there. So we're about to make our skin color here. So what some people actually do is pick up a skin color from the original picture here and create a layer underneath and drop this color. And you can see this doesn't really look like a skin color, although I picked this up from original skin color. So that's why I mentioned you always have to formulate your color yourself. So we're going to be formulating this color together. Let's see. So the reason why I made this whole selection here is so I can easily just pick up a color and drop it, and it's going to fill up around the part I inverted. So the whole part where I selected before is the background. I made this part the background. So whenever I paint, it's not going to go outside the selection. You can see this, it's not going outside the selection. So that was a technique I use here. So let's make a skin color for her now. I'm going to turn off the picture layer and try and make up a skin color for her now. So we know she's dark skinned. So where do we want to put our color wheel? This is the color wheel here. And this is the main color wheel color here. This is the color wheel. You can see the color changing at the corner there. So now we know she's dark skinned. So we are going to put our color wheel in between the region of orange and yellow. Sorry, red and yellow in between that region, kind of like orange. So now we're going to drag the color disc down up to the dark region. But if I use this color, you can see it's looking like chocolate. So I'm actually going to remove saturation from this color by sliding towards the left. So now I took off saturation from this color. I'm making it a little bit lighter. I think it's looking too dark. Let's try this. You can see this already looks like her color, but still darker than her color. Let's make it a little bit lighter. Try it out again. So the thing is, you're just going to keep trying out the color until you're satisfied with what you have. So I think I'm going to add a little bit of red to this color here. Yeah. A little bit better. I think the red I added is too much. Just add a little red. Yeah. Not much. Just a little bit of red. Yeah, I think I prefer this. I think I'm gonna work with this. All right, let me just make it a little bit lighter again. This still looks dark. Does this work? What do you guys think? Because I don't really know right now. All right, I'm gonna work with this. All right, so now we're gonna pick up our skin, the color of our dress. So where do you think the wheel is meant to lie right now? This dress obviously like a dark purple. I'm not really good with color names. I know the base color names, but some other color names, I'm not really good with that. So we know this is kind of purple, so I'm going to slide down our color down to the purple region here. This is blue, this is purple. Yeah, so we're going to drag this down, making it dark, but removing saturation from it. So we know this is actually purple, but ours looks more red than purple. I'm going to add back a little bit of red into this color now. Let's try it out. Oof, sorry. I have to put my reference, my outline on the reference, so that whenever I drop a color on this painting layer, it's going to follow up the lines here, which are completely covered. So, like this. You can see this looks like her shirt, her dress color already. Although it's not perfect. I'm going to try to make it look like very closely. Mine is darker. I'm making it lighter now. Nope, too light. You know what? I'm going to work with this. So I'm going to work with this color we already have here, because I think that's the closest we can get. I can get for now. So now I've done the shirt, I'm going to make a new layer for our hair. I already draw hair on a different layer. I paint my hair on a different layer. So now I've created a new layer. I'm going to try and get the color of the hair. You can see our hair is not black. It's kind of brown, a very dark brown. So I'm taking this color up into red, because that's where brown lies. So I'm removing saturation from it. Yeah, let's try this out. All right, I'm kind of okay with this color I have here. So I'm just gonna fill up these other spots. All right, so now I'm done filling up the hair. So what else I'm gonna do now? I'm going back to my outline, my painting layer. I'm gonna paint the earrings. Alright, so next I'm painting her eyes. You could use a white for her eyes, but I don't know, that's gonna look too artificial. So I'm gonna bring down the color just a little bit here. Alright, so right here we can see her eyes are kind of brown, her pupils are kind of brown. So I'm gonna use this brown here to make this pupil. So now for the lips. Her bottom lips are actually pink, very pink. So what I do first is I pick up the skin tone I already made and slide it up and make it red. For our pink lip color, I think the pink is actually less saturated. And what do we do when the color is less saturated? We slide to the left. So I think this is actually our lip color we have here. Yeah, that's it. Does this look too pink? Okay, you know what? The lip color actually blends into the skin color. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up the skin color again, use a soft brush and fade this quite like there, like this. Yeah. So that looks kind of better. So we can see our upper lip is slightly darker than the bottom lip. I'm taking this down and adding a little bit of red to it. Technical pen here. Let's just pick a color for our nose ring. I should fill this up. Alright, so we are done with the base color for the painting. So now what's left is to shade this picture right now. So actually I have different patterns of shading. I can also just go in shading with a single color here on a layer. I actually create a layer above my painting layer here. Then I will just use the skin color I made and slide it down diagonally to the right, just a little bit. And I always make my shading a little bit red. So that's how I do my shadings. I already test out my color. Sorry, my reference is turned on. I always test out the color first. And I think this is nice. So I can switch shade around with this color just like this. Or the new pattern which I invented is I use the soft airbrush, pick up the skin color and just make it slightly, drag slightly to the right and a little bit down, then add red to it. Then I'm just going to use this color to, I think it's too red. Let me take it a little bit. All right, nope. Let me drag it down, less saturated. All right, perfect. So what I'm going to do now is I'm looking at the reference. I'm just shading around the picture. With this pattern, I'm kind of free. I'm kind of shading around. Just it's like a free shading. This is not the main shading of the picture. It's like a free shading of where it's dark and where it's not dark. So I don't know if you guys can see what I'm doing here, because I'm looking at it from the reference. I'm just shading around every part that is dark. So firstly, before you start your painting and shading, like on the part where you pick up, where you create your base color, you actually be knowing, you actually look at your picture and know where you have chosen as your base color. So right now, everywhere I'm shading across right now, it's not my base color. It's that's areas which are darker than the base colors. I don't know if you guys understand. I'm shading around the darker areas that are darker than my base color. That's what I'm doing right now. Just shading around it under the eye bags. You guys can see this, right? These parts are darker. Then also the edge of her hair here, darker. The edge of her face, I'm gonna make that darker too. So now I'm done with that. I'm gonna create a new layer for my main shading. So now I'm gonna take this down again, diagonally to the right, downwards, okay? Diagonally to the right, and make it a little bit red. Then now using the technical pen, I'm gonna test this out. Let's see how this color looks. Fair, but too light. Let's take it down. You can see I'm just testing out the color. Whenever I make a new color, I always test it out. See that I'm satisfied with it. So I'm kind of okay with this color right now. So let's go ahead and start shading. So the part of shading right now, I'm gonna make the picture layer visible. So the shading is just like the outline. We trace the shading just like the outline. So it's just the same. So what I'm doing here is I'm just looking at my shading and looking at the dark part of the picture. So we can see this is my base color. Here is my base color, which I chose. This is my base color. Around the nose here, it's also my base color. So around this part, also my base color. Although there is kind of light going on around here, you know, these parts are the base colors where I choose. So now I'm looking at the dark areas, which are not the base color. So that's what we're looking at while we do the shadings. So firstly, I'm going to start with the top. So we can see these areas where I'm shading at right now are darker than the base color. But while we are painting, while we are shading on Procreate, we're not going to be shading around the dark parts like this, like we're using crayons. So what we're going to do, since this is digital art, we are going to want to make this shading look as smooth as possible. So that's why we just draw out. I'm just going to draw out through the edge of the shading. You can see this is the edge of the shading. You can see the shading is here like this. Yeah. But I'm not actually going to make my shading look this rough, this edge like this. So what I'm going to do is I'm trying to achieve a smooth kind of shading here. So I'm just going to make the shading smooth as possible like this. My shading lines are going to be smooth. So if I bring back my, you can see how this looks neat. So that's what I'm trying to achieve while I'm shading this. So also, next you can see these areas are dark. Also, you can also see there's a light going on here. But these lights are going to be added later on while I'm doing the light shade. So first I'm going to shade out these dark parts. You can see here is dark. Up to this top part here is dark. Here too is darker. Around the nose here is darker. This area too is darker. Also, don't be scared to make your shadings. All these areas here are darker. Up to the face here, leaving this part. You can see this whole region here is dark. So don't get it confused, like, because I'm just give me a sec. You can see this whole area here is darker. Alright? This whole region, shade that is the darker region. You can see this part is darker region. So don't get it confused, because there are also other darker regions, except for this darker region I'm shading out. So we shaded this whole place as a darker region. But I know some of you will say like the whole part is the dark region. Like some of you would want to say like this is the only darker region here. You want to agree that this is the only darker region here in the picture. This part of the picture. But don't forget, we are painting darker regions that are darker than the base color. So this is actually our base color. Now see, the base color is lighter than this part. So I mean, this part here is also a darker region. That's why I'm painting this whole region here as a darker region. So then we're going to create a new layer for a darker dark after this layer. So let me just finish this up real quick. So as we were painting before, we did the area of the nose. So I'm just going to make this kind of smooth. So you can see these parts are dark around here. I'm trying to make this as smooth as possible. So around the nose here too, you can see these parts are dark. You can't get this 100% exact, but you just have to try and make a good job out of it. So I'm just painting around the dark side. If you're finding this difficult to do, don't follow up my style, because I already know the whole pattern to follow. So if you're finding this difficult to do, you can just easily get it done step by step. That is, there is dark, fill up here first. Here is also dark, fill up here first. Sorry, fill up here first. Just so you won't get confused. You can see this whole region is dark. Fill it up first. You can make your fill up pattern step by step. But for me, I'd rather just make it once, like paint, fill up the old stuff once, like this. That's what I'm trying to do. It's basically the same thing. So you can take your time to fill up these dark areas step by step. But for me, I already know how I'm going to follow this up. So this is the end of the dark areas here. So I'm just going to connect this line to the end of the other line, so that there's no space. So when I drop this line, I see the whole part I painted just filled up. So that's it. So I'm gonna do the other parts. You can see our eyes here are so dark. That's so dark part for eyes here. I'm gonna use a smoother line to fill up these areas. For these corners too, you can see all here is dark. Also, right above our lip. Then, you can see these areas here are kind of looking like that darker, right? But I already made these parts with the shading using my soft airbrush here. You can see I already made those shadings with my soft airbrush. So that's kind of like the importance of doing that. That's what that does. So kind of light shade, you can do that to your soft airbrush first. So now I can see the bottom of the eyes here are dark. So I'll just fill this up like this. I'm just gonna make hand and nose here. Yeah. So let's see how this looks. I see this looks actually nice. So you can as well leave your shading like this if you are scared of going further with much shading and destroying your whole art. So some people might just leave it like this, like, alright, it looks nice already, let me just, we are done. You can as well leave it like this, it's not bad though, but your work is not yet defined. So I always like defining my work more by adding in a new layer of shading, which I call the darker dark. So before I add in this new layer, I'm going to go back to this previous layer and use my soft airbrush to fade out some of the parts where I think are not supposed to be that sharp of the shading. So for example, I'm going to start this top part of the eyes here. Yeah. So I'm going to fade off this part because it's not supposed to be that dark. Just fading it off a little. So also on the cheeks here, on our dark cheek here, I'm going to fade this part off just so it blends a little bit. Yeah. So then where is? Also the other eyes here, this corner of the other eyes. Fill into that part here. Yep. I'm gonna fade up the eye bag too here. Alright, so this is fair right now. So the new layer, I'm creating a new layer now above my previous shading layer. So I'm gonna pick up from my color, which I use for the shading. I'm making it darker again, just like green before. Darker, diagonally to the right, and adding a little bit of red to it. So now we're shading in the darker part, which we didn't concentrate on before. So we are the darker part I'm talking about now, which are these areas where we didn't shade before. So now shading on the darker part, which are darker than the previous shading we made. So that's what I'm looking at right now. I don't like this color. Let's take it a little less saturated. Yeah, better. All right, so on the nose, I actually like starting my shading from making the bottom of the nose a little bit darker and this region a little bit darker, even if it's not so on the original picture. So we're also going to make this part of the eyes a little bit darker. Yeah, so let's just follow up from the picture right now. So I'm going to hide my other layers and follow this up from the original picture. So I'm going to make some parts of this hair here to look a little bit darker, because the original shade we made before was around this region here. Around this whole region here was that we made the dark shade for. So right now I'm going to lessen that and make it kind of around. We're kind of defining our darkness right now. So the first one went all the way down here like this, but this new one is going just above it like this. So we're actually defining our dark shades. So I'm going to fill up from around here all the way like this. Alright, let's check it out. Always check how you are doing if you're not confident yet. So we are checking this out right now. You can see the two spaces in between. This is the first dark layer and this is the second dark layer. So let's do more dark shades here. So I'm going to do some dark shades for this corner of the eyes here, which I can see that are dark, but this edge is here too. So that's what I'm going to do next. Let's check that out again. You can see how this is looking already. It's already looking, your work is already standing out, kind of. It's already kind of standing out. So I'm adding in more dark shades now. I'm going to add up more dark shades to the eyes here, because we can see this part look kind of darker. Kind of a complicated one here. I'm going to end this here and draw this out all the way down here. Finish up. And also for the other eyes too, darker here. I usually like making the corners of the eyes look kind of darker. Normally, I just like doing that. So this region where I made here, I'm gonna use a soft airbrush now to, as an eraser, to fade this part off and blend it into the picture. You can see how this looks now. Really nice. So I'm also going to blend in this other edge of the picture here. So those are just the little things we add to our work that makes it look so damn good. So I'm doing the bottom part of our lip. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me just hide up this stuff here and show you guys. So you can see these areas are darker. I'm going to do this around here too. So you can as well argue that all of these areas are also darker than the original dark. So let me check this out real quick. Yeah, not bad. So you can still argue that these areas are also supposed to be darker. Well, if you wish, you can still go ahead and fill up these areas like this. Most of the time, just try out this stuff. If it doesn't look good for you, then you can still do it. So I just try it out and I don't know. Let's try using the soft airbrush as an eraser to fade it off.
I'm gonna fade this color off in the middle a little bit here. Now it's a bit better. Yeah. Notice the color is showing here. Just fade it off a little bit. So now I think we are done with the dark layers of our skin shading. So let's make some dark shades for our lip. So I'm selecting the skin color, the lip color, the base lip color, going to the first layer here. I'm making it darker. Slightly darker. Adding a little bit of red again. Then I'm gonna trace this from the original picture. So what I'm doing is I'm ignoring all the light I'm seeing here. I'm just focusing on what's behind the light. So you can see these parts are kind of darker. These parts might be complicated, kind of. So these parts are kind of darker. Here is darker. I know this area is darker. It's supposed to be. But this light's actually obstructing it because she is actually on lip gloss. So, but I can see it underneath that these areas are darker. I can feel this up. Like that. So when I put this back, you can see how it looks natural, but it looks nice. So I'm gonna do the bottom part of the lip too, the same way. Dragging down this way, making it a little bit redder. If that's correct, that's our English. So, well, let me try this out first. I always test out my colors before I start in the shading. Not bad. I'm gonna go with this. So, there's really no much dark parts on my lip right now. I'm just gonna put on these edges here, which are looking a little bit darker. Then, just around. I'll put one here and here. Let's go with it this way. Let's check it out. Alright, not bad, looks nice. So then what's left now to do is the new layer for light, for our lighting. So I'll select on the skin tone again, create a new layer above my darkest shade. Then now I'm gonna make this lighter. So I'm dragging it diagonally to the diagonally upward to the left right now. And this video, this should be light enough. You can see our picture is actually lighter than this. I don't know if I'm going to make my shading lighter than this. I'm going to work with this first. Let's go with it. So you can still trace your light shades from the picture, but I won't do that. I'm just looking at it from the original picture. You can see this part of our nose here has light on it. I'm putting that in. Also, our upper lip here has this light on it, light reflection. So what I'm going to do next is follow up. Let me just add all of this light underneath our nose. Yeah, what I'm gonna do next is should I add up this? Yeah, that works. Alright, so I'm gonna fade this little light off here. Let me do it right. I'm gonna fade this off like this. Yeah. Alright. So what I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna use my soft hair brush right now and spray around the rest part of the light part. So I can see these areas of our eyes are light. I'm just faintly spraying this on our eyes. So I'm painting on top of our eyes here because it's light there. Yeah, yeah. I'm just looking at the picture right now. I'm doing this, looking at my reference. Remember when we first started, I mentioned that you need your reference for your shading. You can just look at your reference and do the shadings. Yeah, this is the part where you need the reference the most. So I'm just shading on the part where I'm seeing the light coming from. This is why the part where you need some art skill. Right now, I'm seeing this whole part has light. If your shading is kind of big, the shading part, you know, the part where you know, add light is big, you have to increase your brush size and easily just make it look big. So if you use a tiny brush size and try to fill this whole piece up, it's going to look rough. So that's what I'm going to use a bigger brush size, free top. So I add in the little details, little lighter details to a smaller brush size. Like this corner of the lip, you can see it's looking lighter. This part looking lighter. I think this is too light. Nope. Let me put it here. Yeah. I'm gonna add some more light on this part of our skin here. Alright, so I'm gonna add in some light too underneath the eye bags. I'm just following exactly what I'm seeing on the picture right now. That's just how I do my drawings, following what I'm seeing on the picture. So it's a little bit of light underneath the eye bag. Yeah, I'm gonna use this brush size to put this light here. I'm gonna reduce the brush size down and putting this extra light underneath the eye there. What else? Alright, so right now I'm done with the whole shading of light. So now I'm gonna do the light bound stuff, which I explained on a video on my YouTube. So I'm gonna use the technical pen and shade on the dark part of the picture with just a line following her face structure. This stuff adds some kind of beauty to your work if it's done right. This isn't right, I know. I'm gonna add it up just right underneath here. I'm gonna add around here too. Now this looks better. I'm gonna add a little bit of bounce light on her nose. So what the bounce light explains is part of the face where extra light is bouncing on, like. So I did it on her lip already here. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna do the shading, the light shade for the lip right now. I'm gonna use a really light color right now for her lip, if not white, for this lip glossing effect. Alright, firstly, you know what I'm gonna do first? I'm gonna just select this color, make it lighter, use my soft airbrush and just spray around this area first. There's gonna be a lot of light coming to this place. Let's make it look lighter first. Let's soften them a little bit. So now I'm gonna use white with my technical pen on a new layer, because I don't know if I'm gonna be erasing. So I'm just following up what I'm seeing on the picture. But you can still trace this from the picture, I forgot. You can still trace this from the picture. I'll turn this all off here. Alright, so I'm gonna show back the whole stuff and trace this from the features. Let's see. How does this look? Looks like there's oil on my lip. It's too much. And that's why I made it on a new layer. So just in case this happens, I can as well erase it off a little bit here. Yeah, it looks better like this. Yeah. So now I'm gonna add some glitter effect on my eyes. So right now I'm gonna go above my outline layer. Reason being, I already made. I want to add this light stuff on her eyes here. But if I should do this underneath the outline layer, it's gonna be behind the outline, because I made this dot on the outline layer. That's why I'm making this above the outline. Alright. So this doesn't have to be exact. I'm just putting this in here. Random spots. A little bit more here. Add a little bit more here. Look at good. Nice. Now I'm going back down to my light layer here. I'm going to use a lighter brown for the bottom part of her eyes. Lighter brown here. Just going to paint this in there. Not too much. Can I just make it a little bit like this? Let's see. Alright, not bad. The same goes for the other one. Alright. So, that's that with her skin color and all that. Because I need her skin tone. So, you can see how this looks really nice. So, if I want to make the glows on her nose ring, on her earring, I can do this on my light layer using my luminance pen or whatever app you are on. I'm sure you guys have a glow pen. You can just shine things around like this. Or if you want to go through the other process, you can as well create a new layer. We'll take this underneath the outline, turn this into add, and you can use your normal pen or a soft airbrush and spray the light around you. You can see it works as a glue pen too. So that's actually how to create a glue pen. You can use the art effect to make glows. So this isn't really silver, it's kind of like gold. Maybe this color. No, this looks weird. It's yellow. Yeah, this works. So that's that. Then let's head into our clothes right now. So for our clothes, I'm just gonna create a new layer here. You can see our clothes have this kind of texture of wool, but I'm just gonna use a darker color and just shade the color. The clothes is real simple right here. Setting technical pen and testing out my color. You can see I picked up the color from the original shirt, from the color of the shirt which I formulated. Then I'm gonna take this darker. Let's see how it looks. Alright, not bad, look good. So I'm gonna trace this out again as usual. Tracing around the darker parts, you can see this all area is dark areas of the shirt. Alright, so with all that being done, what I'm gonna do next is use my soft airbrush as an eraser to erase this part which I'm not supposed to be that hard, like around this region. You can see in the original picture it looks faded, yeah. So that's what I'm trying to achieve with the soft airbrush here. Just like we did on our face. So just that. So you can see the clothes already look nice. So I'm just gonna add a new layer. Or we can I've made this on the same layer as I used for my shadings. I don't know why I made a new layer for this. So I'm gonna make it darker for the next dark shades. I'm not tracing this time, I'm just gonna look at the picture and do it already. I'm just gonna add some light layers for the shirt. Make this lighter a little bit, use my soft airbrush and just spray this on here. Randomly. I'm also gonna add the bounce effect on the shirt here. Just around this corner here. And yeah. Not bad. And you can also see we have lost the texture of the shirt. But just for time's sake, on the usual case, we would have drawn these whole lines like this. If you want to do, you can straight draw all the details on your clothes. You can straight draw the whole lines on the shirt like this. Or let's just do it anyways. Let's get it. So I'm going down below here, making a new layer. Let me draw all the lines here. Alright, that didn't really take much time. So it looks roughly done though, but it looks alright at the same time. I'm going to fade out some parts just for the effect. Yeah. So now we can see all that's left for this picture is just her hair. We have the last part of the picture we have is though. So I'm going to add a new layer above the hair layer and select the hair color, make it darker, and then this looks like black. Taking it all the way down and just follow up. You can as well trace the shading from the picture if you wish, but I'm just gonna do this real quick like this. Alright, firstly, before you start making shading your hair, it's advisable you select the hair layer first. Select on the hair layer just so you won't end up drawing into your skin. You can as well shade now, it won't get into your skin at all. So that's the reason I selected the hair layer. These are looking so rough right now, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use my soft airbrush and just fade around the dark part, because this hair is really difficult. I'm not really a fan of hairstyles like this, of drawing hairstyles like this, so this is just how I'm going to do it. Hopefully it turns out nice. Hopefully. Because there's a lot of strings to be drawn here.
a lot of strings to put on here. Because I'm just trying to find an easier way to reduce the time frame of the work. Alright, so this actually kind of works. This actually works. Yeah, it works. So I'm going to create a new layer again and make a lighter shade this time around for here. It's my technical pen, testing out the color. I'm going to reduce my opacity down and it is too light, it's too dark. Okay. Okay. There we go. I'm just putting in some light shades on the areas where I see light coming. I know someone will ask if I like, what if I wasn't on Procreate and if I'm not using a pencil to draw this outline? Like, how would I be doing this here right now? But the thing is, you're just going to have to figure it out. You're going to have to figure out how you're going to make this kind of hair processes on your own. Because the thing about art is, as you go deeper into the drawing, you start realizing ways of how you're going to draw some particular part of the picture. So just get there and start drawing already. As the deeper you get to the drawing, the more you get open to ideas of how you're going to accomplish some parts of the picture. Like when I first started drawing this picture, I was actually wondering, honestly, I was wondering, like, how am I going to do this hair, man? How am I going to make this hair look like hair, actually? But here we are now. We already did it. Although it's not looking that perfect, but it's actually nice. So, putting this on full screen, you can see this looks fulfilling already. So what's left to do now is just to make a background. I think I'm gonna use, I don't know, yellow or pink as usual. Is pink the right color for this? I'm gonna go with this yellow. I don't know. I'm gonna go with this yellow. So yeah, this works. Yeah, this works. This works. Yeah. Alright, so now I'm done with the background, finally, after many hours of trying. So, I'm going to add some little effects on this picture, on the add layer. I'm just going to use my soft airbrush and select my painting layer. When that is selected, I can go up back to the add layer and make some effect on it, like pink lights coming to the picture. Let's use red. Yeah, perfect. Some red light just coming to the picture there and those areas. Perfect. Alright, so that was that for this video. Okay. Well, that was that, guys, for dang, why is it so hard? Alright, so that was that for this video, guys. If you enjoyed this video, destroy that like button as usual. And I'll see you guys in the next video.